welcome to another unpopular opinions video where you guys are gonna get upset, unsubscribe, at me on Twitter, at me on Instagram, and I'm gonna hit you with the blockiana because I'll play that shit. Every single time I do one of these videos, people get mad and they start trying to come at me and tell me to explain what I said. But quite frankly, I said what I said, I meant what I said, and I'll say that shit again. So a lot of these unpopular opinions probably gonna get y'all upset. Meanwhile, a lot of y'all probably gonna agree with me, but nonetheless, you're probably gonna unsubscribe, then you're gonna resubscribe because y'all love me, okay? Y'all know y'all love me, okay? So my first couple of unpopular opinions are all music related. But of course, before we get started, smash that subscribe button, smash that like button, smash every button you know that can help a sister out. Keep the description box for everything that you guys consistently ask me about down below in the comment section. And follow me on Instagram. Why you not follow me on Instagram? And for those of you guys, if you are in New Jersey and you have an LA Fitness membership, please make sure if you enjoy Zumba, you show up to my Zumba class. It is right here on the screen. I'll be West Orange, 8:30 a.m. on Mondays, and I'll be in Newark, New Jersey, 7 p.m. on Fridays. First things first, my first unpopular opinion, and I know it's gonna get a lot of people upset, is that a lot of these artists these days, especially the woman artists, honestly, all these artists, okay, male, female, they're not giving. Okay, they're not, I don't care what anyone has to say, they're not giving, okay? Yes, some of them are really good, okay? Meg Thee Stallion, Chloe Bailey, whatever, they're great, but they're not giving. They're not the Beyonce, they're not the Ashanti, they're not the Maya, they're not the Missy Elliott. They're not what we had growing up. Y'all gotta admit, the level of talent is not there, okay? Little Baby, Da Baby, Tory Lanez, I know he's canceled. Like, all of these artists that we got right now are not giving what 50 Cent, Ja Rule, Genuine, like all these, like, y'all know who I'm talking about, like the old artists, even old Chris Brown, Trey Songz. And the thing is, let's go to kind of like modern, but like kind of old. I'm not even a Nicki Minaj fan really, but even I can say she dominates, okay? She's a good lyricist. I'm not a fan, I don't really care for her music, but she makes good music. She can rap. This stuff that I'm hearing these days, I'm not understanding. It's giving sleep. It's giving, I don't want to even listen to music anymore. Back in the day when I grew up, I literally knew every lyric to every song. Now it's like, I don't even want to, like, I don't even watch music videos anymore. I don't want to listen to music. It's boring. It has no substance. It's just not the same. Like, I don't know. I can't be the only one. And I know there's going to be people like, oh, well, you got to listen to this artist. You got to listen to this artist. Listen, I don't care. Because these artists that you mentioned it to be, more than likely I've listened to them and they just don't interest me or they don't hold my interest. And that brings me to my next unpopular opinion. A lot of the artists that do deserve attention don't get attention, and that really bothers me. And that's mainly because a lot of us are focused on the wrong things. Y'all want to hear about shooting and killing and fucking and sucking, and that's from all fronts, okay? Y'all want to hear that from the men, y'all want to hear that from the women, because a lot of these talented artists that are actually talking about conscious things, that are actually talking about things in the community that makes sense, y'all don't want to hear anything from them, okay? Y'all want to hear about all of the degradation, all of the horrible things. Artists that are actually talking about meaningful things never get not one push. But then when people start doing the Chloe Bailey, okay, and they start selling their soul and they start shaking their ass for a couple clicks, now everybody mad. Now, I don't like what Chloe Bailey's doing either, but clearly it's working because sex sells, and that's what y'all want to see. And the proof is in the pudding. And of course, my next one is, y'all let male artists get away with the bare minimum, but y'all make woman artists literally do backflips to entertain y'all and literally give them peanuts of appreciation. Y'all know what the hell I'm talking about. These male artists get on stage and do a little two-step looking like damn corpses, okay? They ugly as hell. They change probably fake. All they do is disrespect women all day, pop they shit, make little mundane lyrics, probably do a little two-step to a song, and literally probably have a two-step to their song, and literally y'all praise them all day. They make more money than these women because they get more accolades than these women, whatever the case may be. But then these women out here, they gotta put on a full-blown production. just to get any bit of like recognition. And then what do y'all do? Y'all tear these women apart. Oh, the performance wasn't giving, the outfits wasn't giving, she needs to lose weight, she need to get a BBL, she need to gain weight, she need to eat more, she not even cute, isn't that da 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 baby mother, oh blah blah blah, cheating on her anyway, oh my god, why did she have another baby? Y'all sit there, y'all talk all these shit, and y'all expect them to do so much. That's the shit that it blows my mind. These men, they hop on stage, they do a two-step, bro. They just be jumping around stage. Yeah, yeah, fuck, yeah, hot, yeah, yeah, whoa, yeah, turn up, whoa, yeah. And the crowd goes, it's like, what? Now, let me just say, listen, I like the ratchet music too. I turn up to the ratchet music too. No matter who it comes from, if I like a song, I like a song. I'm not saying I'm exempt from this, but at the same time, I'm saying we all collectively have to do better. This is an issue. Why is it that these women are working 10 times as hard as these men, not getting the recognition, not getting the same pay, not getting the same type of accolades at all? It's not fair. It's fucked up. But I do agree, all of them niggas gotta step up. Okay, they all gotta step up. They all gotta do something. Because like the music is just mediocre overall. My next unpopular opinion is you do not have to bring your boyfriend and girlfriend everywhere like they're your purse. Let your boyfriend or girlfriend have their own life. It annoys the hell out of me having friends or knowing people that every time you invite them somewhere, they gotta bring their boyfriend or their girlfriend too. Do you just not trust your boyfriend or girlfriend? If you don't trust your boyfriend or girlfriend, you know you just shouldn't be with them, right? Trust is the basis of all relationships. If you don't have trust, you don't have anything, you don't need to be together. Stop going back to your exes. It's a waste of time. I understand, ladies. I don't want to collect another body. I don't want to spend time getting to know someone else. I'd rather stick to the bullshit I know. Stop wasting your time with this bullshit. If men could sit around and fuck like 10 girls in one day, why are you sitting here limiting yourself to, oh, I'm going to stick to the same toxicity that I know? I'm not telling you to go swing your pussy in a circle, okay? I'm not telling you to go do that, but I'm saying, why limit yourself the opportunity to go out there and explore and get to know different people and limit yourself to the same type of trash when you can literally go out there and find something new? You never know what's waiting for you out there, but instead you want to sit there and limit yourself just because, oh, I don't want to add another body. Fuck society, fuck that whole body standard, and do what the fuck is best for you. Stop subjecting yourself to more toxicity. You know you shouldn't be with that person, you know you shouldn't be giving your body to that person, and you know that person doesn't respect you. And I guarantee you that man is sitting there fucking couple of other girls on top of that. So stop being stupid. That brings me to my next one, and a lot of people are probably gonna be mad about it, but dating apps are not the place to find your forever person. Yes, I do understand that there are people out there who have found their husband or their wives on dating apps. However, it's a very, very small percentage of people, and it's not likely that you will be one of those very small percentage of people. Actually, comment down below if you've actually found your husband or wife on a dating site, because I think that's actually really amazing if you have. But for a lot of people, understand that when they go on a dating site, they look for a quick fuck. A lot of men in particular see that as free P word, okay? Free P-R-O-S-T-U-S-H-I-N. I can't spell. They didn't send me to school for that. So realistically speaking, if you think, oh, I'm gonna get on Tinder and find my future husband, stop it. Just stop it, stop it, stop it. It's unrealistic. A lot of men do not take women on there seriously. They think they're about to just find something casual. Meanwhile, a lot of women on there think they're about to find something serious. And that's why a lot of these relationships do not work. It does not matter how much you put in your bio or how much you express to the people that DM you that, oh, I'm looking for something serious. At the end of the day, the reason they're on there is not to find something serious. And at the end of the day, men, the reason these girls are on here is not to find something casual. So the disconnect is already there, and that's why these relationships are not working. Be honest with each other and stop wasting your time on these dating apps thinking you're gonna find something serious. This is another hot take, but I said what I said. Kids that do not know how to settle down do not belong on vacations whatsoever. I cannot tell you how many times I've been on vacation and I've seen kids that just cannot sit down, cannot be quiet, and I just... I'm sorry, this might be like really assholish, and this is the thing, I love children. And the main reason I don't have children is because I cannot deal with, if the Lord blesses me with a child that just cannot sit down and just cannot behave properly. And I just can't, and I understand there's some things that are beyond your control, but understand, like, especially when you're on a cruise ship or you're on like an all-inclusive resort, you see the same kids. So I'm kind of referring to kids that I see consistently at a resort or consistently at a specific place, like, because if you're on a cruise ship or you're in a resort, you're gonna see the same kid. And like, there's been times I see kids that, like, literally it's like, bro, you should have really left this kid at home. And yes, I know sometimes it's hard to find a babysitter, sometimes it's expensive to find someone to watch your kid or whatever case may be, but some kids, it's like you're kind of just messing up the vibe for everybody at this place, okay? Even at restaurants and stuff like that, it's like, why would you bring a kid that you know is gonna disturb the peace for everybody? And I know, yes, there's some fucked up shit to say to people, and I know a lot of people gonna be really mad at me for this, but I'm sorry, if you know your kid is like really, really rowdy, can't sit down, and does not have a legitimate issue, then like, no, please keep that kid at home. Now, if the kid really does have a mental issue, if the kid has a cognitive problem, if the kid has like a legitimate like issue that cannot be remedy, clearly this does not go for you. Like, there's nothing you can do about it. But if you know your kid just really just bad as shit, keep that kid at home. Keep that kid at home until you're able to rectify that kid's behavior without that child ruining the vibe for everybody else. Because then those be the parents that get mad when everybody else is mad that your kid is fucking up the vibe. Like, no, like, I'm sorry, keep your kid at home. Cats are not low maintenance. A lot of people get a cat and they think, oh, well, all I gotta do is get the cat, feed it, and give it water, and you know, they just go about their business. If you get a cat and you don't pay it any mind, and all you think you're gonna do is just give the cat food and water, understand that cat is gonna turn violent. They're going to become real assholes. They're gonna start tearing up your furniture. And also, cats are very different, specific to their breed and their personality. Not all cats are the same. Some cats act like dogs. Some cats wanna be all up under you. Like, Sage is very much so like dog-like, and she's very, very cuddly. Like, she's the type of cat that will just come walk up on you and like sit in your lap. She's the type of cat that wants to be around people. She starts to feel some type of way if you leave her alone for too long. She starts to feel some type of way if you don't pet her. Like, she's the type of cat that comes up to you and she nudges you to pet her. So she's not a regular cat. There's Bengals that literally like will want to go outside and want to be walked. There's different types of cats with different types of personalities that are different types of breeds that act different types of ways. Cats are not low maintenance, okay? Please do your research before you go get a cat. I have too many people out there that have cats that contact me, or too many friends that have cats and contact me, and they're like, oh my God, there's so much work. My cat is so mean. My cat is tearing up my furniture. I'm like, because you thought that just getting a cat and putting it in the house was going to serve you, but you have to serve the cat too. You have to give the cat what it needs. You can't just put the cat in the house and think it's gonna be all fine and dandy. That's not how it works. Men look weird in flip-flops. I don't understand why anybody thought that men looked decent with flip-flops, but if you're a man and you wear flip-flops, that's strange. You need to stop. I'll be damned if my man ever walk around me in flip-flops. He would never, because he knows that's just strange. Also, men who wear any type of sandals with no sock are strange. That's disgusting. Please put some socks on with your sandals. Please and thank you. Tipping culture is problematic, and we need to hold the companies accountable. I need to understand, why is it that when people don't tip, everybody wanna come at the people, everybody wanna come at the customers or whatever? And yes, I understand, if you can't tip, don't go out to eat, don't order services. But at the same time, why is it not being held on these companies that have millions of dollars to spare to pay their employees a livable wage? We hold companies accountable for everything else. Shit, be dragging Amazon left and right for not paying their employees more, and they even get benefits and all of this extra shit. But these people that literally serve us food and been serving us food from literally like the dawn of time, since the dawn of time, literally can't get a livable wage. I find that really insane to me. I feel like all servers should go on strike, all delivery drivers should go on strike, whatever the case may be, so they can get a livable wage. These restaurant owners or whatever the case may be do whatever it takes to cut costs, and they should not be doing that. They should be able to pay these people a livable wage, and it should not always have to rely on us to tip. That is a problem. They should not have to rely on us to live to the next day. They should not have to rely on us to provide them a livable earning. Like, I don't know, am I the only one that agrees with this? And I know people are like, okay, well, they're just gonna get fired. Okay, there's plenty of restaurants out there. Honestly, I feel like it needs to be a collectible effort. It needs to be something that's done. Everybody wants to be like, oh, well, customers need the tip and customers need this, but it's like, no, customers should. And if you give a good service, then you should be tipped. I feel like tips should be a thing, and I feel like they need to also get paid at least minimum wage, because it doesn't make sense. I don't understand how servers even didn't think about this a long time ago. I feel like servers are the fabric of society, honestly. Like, without servers, how the hell would people get their fucking food? So it's like, the fact that they even put up with getting paid such a very, very low amount for this long is crazy, in my opinion. Reese's Pieces is a crime. Peanuts and chocolate is a crime. Peanut butter and chocolate is a crime. Just that whole combination of any peanuts and chocolate is just problematic, and it just shouldn't be a thing. I like Snickers though. I like Snickers though. You're like, how? Listen, it's not the same. I guess the caramel breaks it up. The nougat, I don't know, but Reese's Pieces is disgusting. The cereal is disgusting. The chocolate is disgusting. The whole thing. And if you like it, there's something wrong with you. I don't give a fuck. I said what I said. Everyone's depressed but don't want to go to therapy, mainly because they out here thinking they depressed, but they probably got another mental health issue, and they also don't want to look in the mirror, and they also don't want to go through the whole situation of getting diagnosed because they probably don't even really have depression. Another thing I really don't like, and it's probably another unpopular opinion, is that a lot of y'all not even really depressed, okay? A lot of y'all probably got some other shit, a lot of other shit, and you're just saying you're depressed because it's trending. It's really irritating to see a lot of people that are not even diagnosed say they're depressed, but they're not even depressed. You got so many different other things, but you're just saying you're depressed because it's comfortable, and you see a lot of other people saying they're depressed. You read a couple articles online. Now you think you're depressed. Go to fucking therapy, okay? The main reason a lot of people don't like going to therapy is because they don't want to sit in front of someone and tell them that they're wrong, they're toxic, they ain't shit, and there's something wrong with them. That's literally what it is. So they take the easy way out. Oh, I'm depressed. Oh, I have anxiety. Oh, I got ADHD. And that's it. They don't want to hear anything else. When meanwhile, you probably have a personality disorder. You probably got bipolar disorder. You probably have melodactyl daydreaming. You probably got all this extra shit, but you don't want to hear that, right? You don't want to hear that some things are your fault. You don't want to hear that you're the one gaslighting people. You want to hear that you don't want to hear none of that. So you're just going to be like, okay, skip it all. I have depression. I'm going to self-medicate. I'm going to do yoga. I'm going to take a couple of vacations. I'm going to drain my bank account. Like, it just don't make sense. Go to fucking therapy. Like, it's not that difficult. And then they use the, oh, well, I don't have money. Okay, but you're buying different wigs every week. You're buying different Jordans every week. You're spending money on fuck niggas and fuck bitches every week, but you can't go to therapy. Okay. And for those of you complaining, I do have a whole video down in the description box on how to get therapy for free, or how to bargain on prices. It's not that expensive. It's about $100 an hour, and all you need is an hour. And a lot of people are actually way cheaper than that. And if you are low income, you can get it for free. Dunkin' Donuts food is actually legitimately trash now. I don't know what they've been doing, but a lot of the food tastes like Play-Doh. I don't like. I don't like a lot of the noodles. I don't like a lot of the new drinks they doing. I don't like a lot of the new situation, the new marketing. I don't know. I like some of the drinks, but like, it's not the old Dunkin'. I miss the old Dunkin'. You know how a lot of us miss the old Kanye? I miss the old Dunkin'. Capitalism makes the world go around. Stop complaining about it. Investing is actually not expensive at all. Stop saying it's expensive to invest. You're just lazy and you don't want to do the research, and you prefer to spend all your money on Shein and sneakers. It's okay. Just admit it. It's okay to rent. You don't have to own a house. I don't understand why everybody is so hung up on this fake boss babe, boss bro type of mentality when they don't know what being a boss is really like. Just like now, everybody wants to be an influencer. Everybody wants to own their own business. Listen, I do this shit full time, and this shit is a lot harder than it looks. It's a lot harder to be your own boss, be accountable, have the finances, budget, and everything when you're literally the only person that's responsible for you. There is no 401k. There is no tax return for us. There is no none of that. So when you have all of this running on your own, when you go to apply for a house, when you go to apply for an apartment, when you go to apply for a car loan, you gotta prove you got all the money. You have to prove that you can pay it. You gotta do all this extra shit. And then even if you don't, like, say if you're just buying a house in a general sense on your own on a regular 9-to-5, it's just so much to maintenance. You go, you buy a house. Say if it's not 100% brand new from ground up, now things start breaking. Now ain't no, oh, call the landlord to fix it. You gotta fix it. And these things are expensive to break. A fucking water heater could be like $10,000 fix. A roof fix could be over $20,000. Like, you guys think that just buying a house is just buying a house, woohoo, whoop-de-doo, and you in the clear. No, there can be so many underlying issues with a house that you don't know. You can have termites in the walls. You can have have so many things that you never even thought about that have an issue. And when you get in the house, that's when you see all the issues. And you guys probably go, okay, but inspections. You think that inspections are really gonna catch everything? Like, let's be real and let's come on now. Like, you really have to really think about these things, especially if you're buying the house by yourself and you're not married. It's even worse because now it's like everything's on you. Ain't no other person to share the burden with, ain't no other income to share the burden with. So it is okay to rent. Okay, it's okay to rent. Even if you want to buy like a condo, it's okay to buy a condo. That's another thing a lot of people are like, oh well, don't buy a condo, there's no point, it's not a freestanding structure. Shut the fuck up. Okay, you can get a return in investment, especially if you are buying a condo in like a high traffic area or like a metropolitan area that is highly desired. Just do your research, know what you're doing, and do what's best for you. Don't be out here trying to follow all these people that don't know what the fuck they're talking about. Don't be out here trying to start a business because everyone else is starting a business. Don't be out here trying to buy a house because everybody out here is buying a house. Don't be out here just getting a relationship because everybody else is getting a relationship, and so on and so forth. Do what's best for you at the time that's best for you, not because everyone else is doing it. And that brings me to my next one. Social media is dangerous as fuck, and that's because everyone is living in an alternate reality, and anyone can be whoever it is that they want to be without being who it is that they say they are. And it's actually really scary. Everyone is putting on a persona. Everyone is like literally saying that they're happy when they're really, really depressed. Everyone's saying that they're depressed when they're actually really, really happy for personal gain. And it's creepy. Like, how many times have we met someone on social media and then we meet them in person and it's like the complete opposite of what they were? And that's a really, really dangerous thing because so many people are able to put on a complete different facade on the internet versus what they are in real life. And that's why I urge you guys, before you see something online and get inspired, do an investigation. Okay, what really happens when you become a full-time YouTuber? What really happens when you go buy a house? What really happens when you go have a baby? Because a lot of people don't really know the logistics of a lot of these things. You just see, oh my god, this baby's so cute, I have baby fever, let me go find my husband and have a baby. Like, no, do research. Okay, social media can be very, very dangerous because it's like it's making people think that they want things or they desire things that they truly don't want. Even from little things like, oh, I want this glass coffee table. Do you know how much work it is to maintain a glass coffee table? It's a lot of work. It collects dust insanely fast. Now, say if you don't have kids now, you might have a kid in 2 years. That glass coffee table could be a hazard to that child. Next thing you know, shit, maybe you're the child and you break the damn coffee table. You know, there's a lot of things that can happen from just, oh my god, I saw it on social media, now I want it. Now you just spent $300 on this coffee table that you didn't really want, but you saw it online, now you want it. And now you just have it and you can't resell it for the same amount of money because it's used. You know, like, you guys don't think about these things, but it's the basic psychology. I feel like social media is fucking with a lot of people's head, okay? And that brings me to my next one. Phones are dangerous, okay? Phones are a really, really big distraction. I've seen phones ruin relationships, phones cause accidents, phones, of course, the social media aspect. And that's because I feel like phones offer a sense of escape. It's like a whole different world on the phone. That's why I always tell people, your phone, you could turn it off. It's a whole different world on the internet versus real life, okay? That's why when people be trying to curse me out or come at me and talk shit, it's like, nigga, I don't even know who the fuck you is. You show up to my doorstep, all right, fine, pull up. But like, if you're not at my doorstep, I don't know who you are. Who do you think you are in my motherfucking phone? I'll block you. That's why when it comes to like cyberbullying, things like that, it's like, I don't know these people. Now, if the cyberbullying is like, oh, okay, well, I know you from school and now you're cyberbullying me, that's different because you know these people in real life. But like, it's complete strangers, turn your phone off, delete your accounts. It's a whole different universe, right? Your phone offers a different escape. And the thing is, there's so many people that are so wrapped up in their phone that they don't know the difference. That's why, like, you know, these family vloggers, these couple vloggers or whatever, they're always in issues because they don't know how to separate it. They don't know when to put the phone down. They don't know when to put the camera down. They don't necessarily know when enough is enough. When should we not experience this? When is a moment to film? When is a moment not to film? They just go, go, go all the time. And it's like, no, sometimes you have to put the fucking phone down. Not everything has to be on your story. Not everything has to be a vlog. Not everything has to be on social media. And I feel like that's what's going on with the phones now. It's like everybody gotta capture every fucking moment. Not everything gonna be captured. And even if it's gonna be captured, not everything gotta go on social media. Like, mind you, this is my job. I get paid to post shit. And I'm not always trying to capture a moment. You know? Like, I'm not always sitting there like, oh my god, let me capture this, let me do this, blah, blah, blah. Like, cause I don't give a fuck. I wanna live life. If people took the time to actually love themselves, the world would actually be a better place. Just like if people went to therapy, the world would be a better place. I actually feel like therapy should be something that is like paid for by the government. It should be like a government assisted situation. But of course, that would probably never happen. Everyone wants to be a true crime crime YouTuber, but no one cares about the victims. I said what the fuck I said. I literally think there's only maybe 3 YouTubers that actually care about the victims that they're talking about. But most of these YouTubers started out as beauty gurus, story timers, and then all of a sudden their channel started to tank and they started talking about victims. And now all of a sudden they care about the victims. A lot of these people don't link not one charity, don't talk to any of the victims' families, and all they do is post for personal gain, and every video is a sponsor. Nobody thinks that's a problem now. I will say, in retrospect, there's not much different that these people do as opposed to like ABC, you know, 2020 and stuff like that, because on TV, these people are making a profit too, right? But the problem here is, at least when like ABC and 2020 or whatever do it, Netflix, Hulu and stuff like that, that's a whole nother story, because a lot of times these families tell these people not to do these documentaries and they do it anyway, so I don't fuck with that. I don't ever watch any like true crime series or whatever like that on those types of shows. I mean, on streaming platforms, because I know a lot of times the families really don't agree with them. But when it comes to ABC, 2020, stuff like that, at least the families are usually involved. Like, at the very least, I get to hear from the families. It's not a biased opinion. It's not like just a story. And the money is not just going directly to a YouTuber and then a sponsorship on top of that. I just find that very odd. Like, I don't, am I the only one that finds that odd? And listen, I enjoy the content to an extent, but I literally probably only watch like maybe one true crime YouTuber, and that's Kendall Wright. And that's because she actually donates to charity. That's because she actually has the families on her channel. And then there's probably a couple of others. I can't even remember their names off the top of my head right now, but that's also because like they'll bring attention to minority cases, like cases I would have never heard about if it wasn't for their channels. But like, there's people that sit there and like they just sensationalize stories that we've heard about time and time again. It's like, what the hell is the point of you doing this story other than for views, clicks, notoriety, and attention? And then they're sitting there talking about some mystery and makeup. Oh, my bad. Did I just throw shade? My bad. But you guys get the point. Like, I mean, there's a couple channels that do mystery makeup though. Like, it's just like, it just minimizes the importance of the case. And let me just say this right now. If I end up to have an untimely death, I mean, we're all gonna die anyway, right? Do not let any of these fucking YouTubers make no videos about me. Talk about some, the YouTuber, the Mademoiselle, she was 27 years old when she was killed and blah, 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 blah. She was loved by her 300,000 subscribers and her 21,000 subscribers on Instagram. Don't fucking let these bitches sensationalize my story for no damn clicks and views. If you see these hoes doing that shit, go drag they ass. I swear to God, do not. I'm giving you permission to drag it. And I know there's some people that like, you know, they just like to take their crime in different doses. Let me tell you this right now, right? The victims do not have a word in how their stories are told because they're dead. How dare people sit there and be like, oh, well, I like my crime told in different doses. Oh, well, sometimes it's easy for me to digest the information when someone's doing their makeup or eating. Well, the dead people can't eat or do their makeup anymore. You selfish pieces of shit. I just feel like if you're going to hear someone's story about how they lost their life, you should hear it in its entirety, the way it's supposed to be told. It just infuriates me. It infuriates me. And I'm telling you this right now, if I ever have an untimely death and some crazy thing happens and it's worth a video, don't let these hoes make a video about me. Only Kendall Wright. She the only one. She the only one, because everybody else, disrespect. Disrespect. Yeah, there's no use in trying to save the environment because we're all gonna die and the earth is going to shit anyway. Yeah, that's a hot take. Like, that sounds so bad. But I mean, like, this whole, all this, these little initiatives, do y'all not understand the humans fucked up the earth? And at the end of the day, it's all in God's hands. If God wants to throw the earth to hell, he's gonna do that. All of these things, and that brings me to my next one. These like little paper straws, they ruin my drinking experience. I would like plastic back, because we're all gonna die. And this is not gonna be solved in our lifetime. This is gonna be for our grandkids, grandkids, grandkids to figure out. Genuinely not my problem. Coffee tastes like dirt, unless it's full of sugar, cream, and milk, and at that point it has absolutely no nutritional value. But at that point, I think you guys are just addicted to the caffeine. So if you're saying that coffee tastes good, you're full of shit. Love is not a choice, because you can't help who you love. But being in a relationship with that person is a choice. So if you're sitting there, you fall in love with your sister's man, or your best friend's boyfriend, or whatever the case may be, and you're talking about something, I can't help who I love. You can't help who you love, but you can help you open your legs to. You can help what you put your dick in. Stop being stupid. Don't be out here trying to use mundane quotes to justify your ain't shit behavior, okay? You can always stop your actions before they become ain't shit. You do not have to go after people that you know you shouldn't be with. There's absolutely no reason in hell you should be out here breaking any life codes, okay? Girl code, bro code, family code, whatever the case may be. If you know you're falling in love with someone that you should not be falling in love with, that's because one, you initiated the behavior in the first place, because you can't just fall in love at first sight. This ain't no Romeo and Juliet. It ain't 1466. I mean, it's possible, but at the same time, it's because you're initiating some sort of behavior, or that person is initiating some sort of behavior with you. So you cut off contact. You have to actively initiate the process to actually stop the process from happening as well. You can't just be like, oh my God, I'm actually attracted to this person, so I'm gonna stay in the house. I'm gonna make sure I'm there. I'm gonna make sure I'm around this person as much as possible to foster this relationship and make sure it grows. Separate yourself from the person. Distance yourself from the person. Don't sit there and make the shit worse. And then now that has gotten so far to the point where now you're in love with the person, you're like, oh, love is not a choice. Love is a choice. You chose to be a bitch. You chose to be a whore. You chose to be with this person. And now you're in some shit and you talk about some love is not a choice. Suck my dick. Yes, it is now. You're choosing to be a bitch, okay? You're choosing to be an ancient person. Now you're choosing to be with the person that you know you're not supposed to be with. Stop that shit. Kill that noise. Oh my God. People are way too concerned about other people's business. Am I the only one that finds it weird that gossip sites are a thing? It's one thing to talk about other people's lives and gossip in terms of it affecting us as a social sphere, right? Like, say if Michelle and Barack Obama were breaking up, that would kind of affect the Black community as a whole, right? Because that's a very, very big situation. That's the former first Black mixed president, whatever we're considering him now, because the Black community loves to change its mind, you know, breaking up or whatever the case may be. That would be kind of big. It would kind of change the social dynamic of how we see relationships, you know, or something along the lines of just like Beyonce and Jay-Z. You know, that's a very, very powerful pop culture relationship. But like little mundane shit, like little babies relationships, or like somebody like I love Rihanna, trust me, but like us talking about Rihanna's pregnancy every 2 seconds, why is that even important? Like, can someone please explain to me why gossip sites are important? Like, I understand that we care about celebrities for whatever reason a lot, but why do we care about them so much that we have to keep up with them all the time? Now, this is something that I really had to address a while ago, because like a lot of people always wanted me to like cover these celebrity topics, but then I realized over time, even though it gives me views and whatever, and of course that generates money, I realized I really don't give a fuck to keep up with these celebrities because they do nothing for me. It does nothing for you. And what is the point? Like, this is not meaningful content. I feel like it really chops down to the point where like it really just distracts us from how fucked up our lives are. So when we see someone that has so much money, so much power, and so much whatever, it kind of just distracts us from what's going on in our lives. So it's like, ooh, what's going on over there? And it just, you know, we forget what's going on with us. The only time I know what's going on is when someone hits me up like, yo, you know, da-da-da-da-da. And I'm like, it has nothing to do with social issues. It has nothing to do with a grand scheme in terms of racism, colorism, stuff like, I really don't care. Like, it does not affect us as a whole. I don't see why it matters, especially when it comes to relationships. I really never really touch on relationships because I feel like that's a touchy subject, and I would not want anyone to really be out here reporting on my relationship like that, because I just think that's a boundary people just should never cross. No, like, it's just a no for me. So that's a thing. I just feel like that should not be a thing. I don't know. I feel like tabloids and all of that are just damaging, and that's probably why relationships never last in the celebrity realm. And that brings me to my next point. I feel like celebrity couples are pointless. I feel like celebrities should probably not date each other because it never lasts. It's kind of a waste of time. There's very, very minimal celebrity couples that actually stay together, and I'm very sure behind closed doors there's a lot of fuck shit going on, okay? And I guess it has to do with money, power, status, assets. It could be a lot of different things, but they just never last. So I don't even understand why they even try at this point. Like, I love Rihanna and I like ASAP Rocky, but let's be real, that shit's not gonna last. Like, I give them a year. Let's be generous, 3, but I give them a year, and it's already kind of falling apart. She should have never said she was pregnant. She should have kept that shit private, because now every day it's a new thing. Rihanna took a step outside and her blah blah blah. It's like, who cares? Let the woman live in peace. High school sweethearts are usually never happy. They're only together for the title of saying they've been together since high school. Same thing as college sweethearts. Most military people cheat. I know this from experience. everyone on YouTube wants to be a video essayist, but no one has a real opinion. Everybody's dry as fuck. They just getting on the mic like, hello, today we're gonna be analyzing the blah 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 of blah blah blah. We're not gonna be telling my opinion today. Like, it just be a whole loop of like fucking Google search. It's like, what the fuck was the point of the video? Like, some of them be interesting, but it's like everybody's doing the same format. Mic in front, LED lights in the background, maybe some shelving, maybe a little plant. And it's just like, I understand these videos get a lot of views, but it's like, y'all are so boring. Oh my god, like, I don't, YouTube's getting real boring, bro. Like, I ain't even gonna stunt. I was like, oh my god. Like, as I was sitting here on my break, I was sitting here watching videos and I just kept skipping videos. Like, I never really skip YouTube videos. I'm like, yo, there's nothing to fucking watch. And of course, my final unpopular opinion is the beach is disgusting. I don't know why they exist and it's only good for photos. If you ever see me on the beach, I'm only there to take pictures and stick my little feet in the water because it's hot outside. I don't understand why people like it because I don't even like the summer. A lot of people been asking me, oh, what's your plans for the summer? What you doing? My life is summer vacation. I can take a vacation when I want because I work for myself. I don't do summer break. I do life break. I don't like the summer. I think it's disgusting. It's hot as fuck. I don't like the beach. I think it's disgusting. The sand is nasty. Did you know? I just found out. Did you know that sand is fish poop? That's nasty. Anyhow, with that being said, thank you guys so very much for watching this video. Please comment down below, what unpopular opinions did you agree with? What unpopular opinions did you not agree with? What are your unpopular opinions? Comment them down below. Of course, peep the description box for information that you guys need. And always ask me about down below. Like, share, subscribe, do all that. Get your merchandise. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye!